Hey, what's going on, man? It's Sarah Potenza.
Hey, Sarah Potenza. Nice to talk to you. My name is Deuce. My co-host, Brandy, with me.
Hello.
Hey, what's happening?
Thank you so much for taking time out of your day. You've got to be very excited right now. You've got a lot going on in your life all of a sudden, right?
Got a lot going on, man. Crazy.
I'm sure it is. It's got to be quite an adjustment, too, right? Just all of a sudden, it's like, oh, we need you to call these goofballs on the radio, and we need you to do this, and we need you to take photos here.
And I'm like, why am I talking to these people? This guy's name is Deuce? What is this?
It's his first name, his last name.
But I'm like, I'll do it. I'll do it.
Thank you for the sacrifice. I appreciate that.
You got it, man.
And I also, I have to say, between you and Graham Elliott, that chef and judge on MasterChef, I think you guys have revolutionized the white glasses industry.
We're revolutionizing things. Yeah. I mean...
The white frames have never been big.
I don't know this Graham Elliott fellow, but I'm going to Google now. I'm going to Google him.
Oh, you guys, you need to team up and find some company. You could really take things to the next level. Endorsements with a Ray-Ban. You know, let's get this thing rolling.
Let's get it rolling. I want aviators. Blue blockers. Make them.
Get your white blue blockers going, right?
Please.
That sounds incredible. We were just watching some of your videos on The Voice and your performances, specifically your blind audition and how you just kind of blew everyone away. Your move, I mean, you do all of that incredible roots rock, kind of classic rock, just rock and roll style so well. Has any of your heroes reached out to you or said anything about you that's really sticking out in your head?
No, but the guy who plays Victor on The Young and the Restless tweeted about me.
Really? Yes. Oh, that's awesome.
His name is Eric Braden.
I was going to say, it's Eric. Yeah. I can't remember his last name.
Eric Braden. I think it's Braden.
All right, now I'm looking him
up now.
No, it
is. He's been on there forever.
Yeah, he's been on there since, like, the year I was born.
Like, wow. 15 different wives, 10 kids.
You know you've reached the big time when soap opera royalty are acknowledging your presence, right?
Exactly. Well, my dad was really excited because he watches his soaps every day.
Well,
Bob watches soaps.
Isn't it so funny what people regard as, like, that's a landmark moment? It's like, you know, oh, I was on national television. I was performing songs that mean so much to me. Oh, but then the guy from the soap opera tweeted about it, and now my family's very impressed.
Well, it's been cool. I went to the Grand Ole Opry.
Oh, that's awesome.
Tonight when I was home, and the management there, like, invited me backstage, and then they, like, brought me out on stage and introduced me and stuff, so that was cool.
That's got to be amazing. Yeah, I mean, place with such history.
Yeah. Pretty nuts.
How did you get from just being a person who was singing their songs to getting that audition on The Voice? What was that process? Because I know a lot of people think, oh, I'm going to get on one of these shows, whether it's American Idol or X Factor or The Voice, and then just launch into superstardom. What was your path?
I auditioned for The Voice and they turned me down. And then they saw me on YouTube later that year, and I had bought new glasses because I used to just have a pair of brown glasses. I'm serious. And they saw me on YouTube, and they said that when they saw the video, they had to press play because they loved the way that I looked in the glasses. They loved the glasses. They wanted to see they were just curious because they saw the glasses. It's true. I put my name into their system to see if I had auditioned, because if I had, they would have my phone number in their database. And they called me and asked me if I would audition.
Wow.
And so I was like, okay.
It is the glasses. And is that terrifying when you finally get that shot and it's like, okay, I got to go in. I got to impress some people who are pretty big heavyweights in the music industry.
No, I think the scariest thing was that I wasn't, like, nervous, but it was the weird part is, like, when you walk out on the stage, everyone's quiet. So, like, normally at, like, a show, like, you would walk out and people would cheer, you know? So, like, you just walk out there and you could hear, like, your own shoes, like, click-clack, click-clack, and you're like, oh, crap, okay. And then, you know, like, the song starts and you're up there and you're like, oh, please let somebody turn around. I'll just be so embarrassed.
Anybody, I don't care.
And yeah, like, please. But I wasn't, like, that nervous about the audition because, I don't know, I'm just the kind of person that, like, I just do my own thing. So I didn't care. I was like, well, I'm just going to go do my thing and be Sarah. And then we'll just see if they like me or not.
Right. If they don't want you for who you are, then...
Then that's okay.
Right.
That's okay with me. Right. You know, but they did. They liked me.
Was that another thing, too, with the blind audition, that they couldn't judge you by your glasses or your hair or the clothes you wore?
Yeah, that was kind of cool because a lot of times people see me and they either really like me or they really don't. So I think I'm very polarizing with, like, my kind of, like, fat, crazy, like, rock and roll look where people either are, like, into it and they're like, oh, my God, like, I love that. That is so awesome. Or they're just like, I can't stand that. That is, like, ridiculous. So, I didn't really know what the coaches would think, but I didn't have to worry about that because I just, like, knew that they would just hear my voice.
Right. So you kind of you get past that initial judgment. You can just get right to what you do.
Exactly.
Right. Now, you guys are, you're going out on the road, right? Is that kind of the next step in the process? Are you touring with The Voice?
No, not yet. The next step in the process is that shows go live.
Oh,
and we like still compete. Okay, so like the last two things that I did was, so first I did the blind audition.
Yeah.
And then I had to do the battles and the knockouts, which is when you have to get in a boxing ring with your opponent and sing, and they sing, and you have to sing better than them.
You did Gimme Shelter on that one, right? That was the the showdown?
That was the first boxing ring, and then there was another boxing ring after that. And I won both boxing ring experiences.
Wow. It's getting very aggressive with the boxing ring. That sounds awesome. Now, you know, if you had an opportunity, we talked a little bit about how you've got that very rock and roll style, and you did, you know, Stay With Me was your blind audition, and, you did Gimme Shelter by the Stones in your first kind of duel there. What would your dream collaboration be if you could go into the studio or on the road or just do a performance with any band or any musician? Who would your pick be?
There's this guy named Charles Bradley.
Okay.
And actually, he lived in Poughkeepsie for a while. He's older. He's, like, in his 60s. He's this, like, kind of this soul artist. He writes these songs about, like, his own life and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And the way that he sings, and he just gets out all this raw emotion, he's kind of my dream collaboration.
Really? Interesting.
Yeah.
I love that choice. That's a really interesting pick because, you know, so often you hear people like, oh, I'd love to be with Paul McCartney and I'd love to perform with David Bowie. So I love that you picked somebody it's kind of like, wow, that, you know, really means something to me and somebody who's got really soulful approach to music.
It really does mean a lot to me.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Well, Sarah, now that you've moved to Nashville, what is the next step? I mean, you're going to be doing this stuff on The Voice. Hopefully you'll be the one that gets the recording contract. And then what else do you want to reach for?
Well, I wrote all these songs, and I think that they're the best songs I ever wrote in my life, and I really want to record those songs and have this album of these songs see the light of day. And, you know, if I just record them by myself, then they're just going to, like, get sold out of the back of my van while I drive around, just like every record I've ever done. And I really want these songs to make it, you know, they might not be, like, all these songs are going to make it on mainstream radio or whatever, but I think that these songs could be big, like Alabama Shake's big, and that they could, you know, help people throughout their day. They could be somebody's favorite songs, and I love to do that. That's kind of like what I really want to do is make this record.
Well, nobody writes songs for them not to be heard. You know what I mean? Everybody wants them to hit that right audience, and hopefully, you know, when somebody writes a song, if they're lucky, it finds the pocket of people it was meant for, and it means a lot to them. So that's a really cool goal.
Exactly. That's what I really want to do.
And don't you think, too, that Nashville is more conducive to that than, say, New York or L.A., too? They're more supportive?
Yeah. Oh, absolutely. That's why I live there. But the thing is that I need money to make the record.
It's weird how that works.
Money?
Yes. I need, like, $50,000 to make the record and to get a publicist and a radio press, you know, all the stuff.
Mm-hmm.
I have about $300. I need $50,000. So we're going to work on that with The Voice.
Well, you know what? First of all, I want to say thank you so much for your time, taking time out of your day to talk to us. We'll be pulling for you, hoping you get
that. We'll be following you, too, in The Voice competition.
Oh, thank you so much for being interested and wanting to talk to me, you guys.
Of course. And we're going to do what we can to make that Ray-Ban thing happen for you, too. So we'll
yes, please. What's the chef's name again? I have to look him up.
You got to look up Graham Elliott's.
Okay, I'm going to do that.
Look them up. You guys, it's like, it's unbelievable how at the same time, boom, white frames taking over.
I'm going to look them up.
Thank you so much, Sarah. We really appreciate your time.
Thank you so much. You guys have a great day.
You too. Take care.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.